Okay guys, before we move on to array, there's a simple philosophy that I want to share. Now, this particular thing is not actually completely theoretical. It's just a way that we want to teach things here. So just to cover, because this may be some students who are studying it directly from us in their college days, please do not write the things that you are saying in the exam or they will fail you. But if you understand these things very properly, you might get complete marks on that. Okay. So I think most of the times we actually study things, we have advantages and disadvantages for these. And I would like to discuss those and why they are true or not true, or it's flexible based on the definition. So one advantage which is told for an array is constant time access. Okay, it's basically that regardless whether I'm asking the first item or the 100th item, it's constant time. It will take a fixed amount of time, whether it's the first item or the last item, right? And we have discussed that, and that the reason behind that is your cache memory. So you should know that particular thing. After that, another benefit is, what do you say? I'm not sure if they actually put it that way. Continuous allocation. Now that is a choice that you have made. This is not an advantage or disadvantage, right? Other than that, what is it? Constant time access. Okay, so constant time access, constant time access is that. So you can mention that as a direct access, or constant time access, like I can calculate, or just mention it that I can calculate the address of desired item in constant time. That is because you can calculate the address of the item directly. Okay, you can calculate the address from the first item's address, which is called as a base address, plus size of data structure times the index. Like, you know, want the 10th item, so mention 10, 9, 8, like that. Okay, so these are some advantages. Now, for people who are confused in these two, for fetching an item, there are two processes. First, you have to do one thing. First, you have to get that I want this particular item. What is the address? That is step one. Okay, that is fast because we can calculate the address directly. After that, it has to go through the physical machine. Okay, it has to go in the hardware and extract that value. This particular process is step two, where having a cache memory helps array and not the other data structures. And here, having continuous memory allocation with fixed data structure helps the array to find the address faster. So finding the address is also faster, and fetching the value from the hardware is also faster. So both of them are separate, and both of them as a plus point for array. Okay, but to get to this particular point, we actually have to lose a lot of things as well. Single data structure, so I cannot have multiple data structures here. Okay, another disadvantage, and that is true because if I don't do this particular thing, I can't have this value. Okay, if I have multiple data structure, what data structure weight will you actually put here, right? So you can't put that particular thing if you have multiple data structures. So property will be lost. We don't want that. We want to be fit. So we will not eat junk food, right? The next disadvantage is, and this is something I said, I don't believe it's true, is constant memory declaration. So they say that, okay, you have to have only a fixed constant memory. Like if you want N, you will only get N. You can't make N into N plus 1 or N plus 2 and N plus 3. This is something I don't agree is true, and that is not only me. A lot of people actually believe that this is not actually a restriction, because there's a solution called as dynamic array, and as you have seen, it doesn't have a complexity problem as well. So in practice, there will be no difference. So I wouldn't suggest you to write this problem. Now, this is basically the discussion about arrays. One thing which I just want to share before we start into linked list is how linked list was actually, let's assume that was started, is one way, the problem that actually led us to dynamic array would actually lead us to linked list as well. For example, if you remember, we said that, okay, we have filled this particular space. So the next time we need more space, we will actually take twice another space, and I'll copy this thing here. Okay. And then I will fill in this space. Once this space is also consumed, I'll ask for a memory allocation of twice the size, which is 4 items. I'll copy these two first, and then I will start filling items in here, right? What if, let's say I don't have any space for 8 items here anymore, right? And I still have filled all this item. I know that, okay, my phone is showing that I only have used, let's say, how much is this? 4 into 6, 20, out of 24 GB, I've only used 6 GB. but I can't allocate more. So what can I do there? So there's one smart guy that said, okay, do one thing. Since these two items are actually cleaned out, because once I have copied, I will delete these data, right? So these items are cleaned out. So you actually haven't even used the 6 GB. I've just used 4 GB. So let's do one thing. We can't have a lot of space. So what I'll do is that I will use this space. I'll say this is 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's say this is 14 and 15. So after 4, I'll write a code here that once this thing is reached, you go start putting things here. Okay. Once this thing is filled out, let's say these spaces are not to be used. This space is left. You go here. So we will add this kind of a pointer. Okay. This kind of a pointer. And this will keep telling me that as soon as this thing is over, I'll come here. This thing is over, I'll go there. And so on. So in this particular way, I can actually use the data once I don't find any more space for my continuous allocation. Okay. And that is, if you know what a linked list is, this is basically what a linked list is. Now, there are a lot of properties of a linked list, a lot of unconventional things which are there for us to teach you about linked list, but that we will discuss in the coming lectures from now onwards. This was just to show you that when you actually need more space, this is one more solution, because let's say that other spaces are actually taken by other program or software systems or something like that. So you can actually take small bits and pieces, connect them using a pointer, and still have a lot of memory utilized. And this is one of the disadvantages of the array, which we didn't mention because none of the books actually mention it. If you use continuous memories only, and your chips, let's say, are like this, and you want eight continuous boxes, you cannot have it. Okay, so there's a restriction on the using continuous memory in case of array as well, if there are multiple systems running together. Okay, so hopefully this particular set of videos might have given you some new perspective in discussing these things. And if so, you can go ahead and like our channel, our pages. So those pages are here on the screen. And you can either follow us on Instagram or YouTube. Both of them have separate content. Prefer to like and subscribe to both of them.